The Ultrabeat software instrument is admittedly daunting at first glance. If you're familiar with how typical drum machines work, you'll be flying with it in no time. If not, no problem. We'll go over some of the basics of Ultrabeat in this video. Let's open Ultrabeat by double-clicking on the plugin. Next, we'll load up a drum kit by going to the preset menu. Let's try Minimal Electro Kit. Loading a kit loads up to 25 individual drum sounds named on the left in the assignment section. As you can see, these sounds correspond to MIDI notes on your MIDI keyboard. They use typical general MIDI mapping. C1 is your kick drum, D1 is your snare, F1 is your hi-hat, if your sound set has those types of sounds. Each sound also has a simple mixer next to it, where you can control level, pan, solo, and mute. Each sample can be altered by using the large synthesizer section window to the right. You select the sound you want to alter and change the controls over here to alter that sound. These are synthesizer controls like low frequency oscillators, LFOs, noise filters, and other types of filters that can alter each sound. Once you're happy with the sound of the kit, you can use Ultrabeat like any other software instrument and play or record MIDI events using Logic's Arrange window. But the thing that really sets Ultrabeat apart from other instruments in Logic is that it has its own internal sequencer. That's what the controls are at the bottom of the plugin window. Turn on the pattern sequencer by clicking its On button on the bottom left. To see a better view of the patterns, let's switch over to Full View. This button's located on the bottom right. Now you can see all sounds in a grid-like pattern view. The grid has 16th note divisions and goes for 32 steps. There are always 12 already loaded up patterns for you with every preset. This is the first pattern. Let's hit play on the sequencer and listen to it. Hit stop to stop playback. You can switch to the other 11 preset patterns by opening up the pattern pull-down menu, located here at the bottom. These are the 12 already preset patterns. We were listening to number 1. Notice that they correspond to MIDI notes on your keyboard. To make your own pattern, go to an empty pattern in the pull-down menu, like 13. Here we have a blank pattern grid. Let's create a 4-on-the-floor kick beat. We'll select Noise Kick as our active instrument. Let's put the kick on beats 1, 5, 9, 13, 17, 21, 25, and 29. Let's hit play to hear what we've done. Cool, that's a start. Let's make a snare drum. On the canned snare track, let's put the snare drum in on 5, 13, 21, and 29. Let's hear what this sounds like. Sounds good. Let's make our hi-hat sound by dragging on the closed hat lane straight across on every beat. Let's hear what this sounds like. Sounds good. Now, let's go to our pattern pull-down menu and right-click to copy this pattern to the clipboard. Now let's open the pull-down menu and go to the next available empty pattern. Here we'll right-click again and paste this. Now we're going to add a couple different sounds to this next pattern. We'll put mid and high zaps in various locations. Let's check this out. Let's make one more pattern. We're going to go to the next empty pattern in the pull-down menu. And for this one, let's make a snare drum beat that goes across every beat of the whole pattern. Now let's right-click in the velocity area and let's alter the velocity. This gives us a differentiation with the feel of the drum beat. Let's hear this. Cool, now we've made 3 patterns. At this time, we can bring these patterns out into the Arrange window. To do this, we're going to go to the first pattern we made, which is number 13, and it'll take this pattern and bring it into our Arrange window as a MIDI region. Let's do that with the next 2 patterns we made. Now, we'll want to turn the pattern sequencer off. This way, Ultrabeat will be able to play the pattern from the MIDI regions in the arrange window. Let's hear this. Cool. Now we know a little more about working in Logic's Ultrabeat instrument. It's one of the most complex tools to get into in Logic, but now you'll be able to get rolling with it.